Good morning, my dear students. Today we would like to discuss last area of our this module. It's a very simple area. That's all about we are discussing e-learning and e-libraries, e-books, video application, audio application of video, etc. in e-learning. So see the last area, that is major technologies used in e-learning. Now we are running or we are walking through the e-learning process. There are a number of technological changes have been emerged as a result of this COVID or lockdown in the process of e-learning. Students and teachers are almost they are packed or they are equipped and they are trained with using this e-learning applications, e-learning strategies, e-learning platforms. They are shifted from traditional learning and teaching platform into the e-learning platform. Okay, so now we are searching new and improved version of e-learning applications and method of e-learning process. Okay, so we can see what are the applications or what are the technologies that can be used in e-learning process. Some of them are listed here. Many applications and technologies we have while we are searching through Google or through Play Store. Different Blackboard, Whiteboard, Zoom, apps, many applications and technologies we can have in the learning process. Some of them are listed as a part of your syllabi. Let us discuss in brief. First one, that is mobile learning. All of us, we know how to use this mobile in the learning process. We are all learning. We are all learning each and every A to Z programs with the help of this mobile phone. Only because of we are reached in a destinations which is not familiar with us, we are using navigation or GPS. Okay, with the help of this mobile we are learned. And suppose we are visited in a country where languages we are not familiar, we are not familiar with the languages in that country, what we have to do? We are using a language converter. So in this way we can use this mobile phone in learning process. It's an ability of an individual to obtain or provide educational content on a personal pocket or a personal digital assistant, PDA. Smartphone or mobile phone, Android phone, are these devices with access to internet connections or with the availability of the resources on itself will be the great source of learning. It is considered to be the best and very cheap and fastest platform for e-learning because of the potential to reach mass data, and it is easy to use and it is also very very cheap. Today, smart mobile phones with a huge memory and faster internet are available, and this makes the user to learn everything he desire at any time, and it is also very easy to handle and it is portable. So why? Because of this mobile is inevitable part of e-learning process. We know some of the mobiles which are very very fast and with high memory than the computer, 8 GB, 10 GB, etc. mobile phones which are available here. Okay, so the performance of this mobile in e-learning process is far better than the computer. So in such a way, mobile phone can be used in e-learning process, that is mobile learning. The next two, that is micro learning. Micro learning means that involves learning in a smaller steps and goes hand in hand with traditional e-learning. That's called a micro learning. For example, rather than trying to teach a students about a broad subject all at once, Aspects of the topic will be broken down into smaller lessons, plans, or objects. This is called micro learning. So, smaller bit, that is micro. Micro learning is a way of teaching and delivering content to the learner in a small, very specific modules. Suppose we are taking to our subject, business, what we say that, professional business skill. That is a macro subject. It's a macro study. While we are putting each and every lessons or a concepts, what we have to do? We are using micro learning process. Okay. This, it is designed and delivered in rich media format. It is a learner-centric approach that provides just-in-time training that is available on multiple devices. All these aspects ensure that it can be easily accessed, quickly completed, and easily applied by all the learner. Get it? That's all about micro learning. The next one, the very important learning mechanism, that is Internet on Things, IoT. We are all, we know, IoT means Internet on Things. Now, it refers to the over growing network of the physical things or objects around us, which hold IP addresses, Internet protocol addresses, or Internet connectivity. And the communication that occurs between these connected objects and other internet-enabled devices and systems. It includes not only traditional things like desktop or laptop or a smartphone or tablet, etc., but all other things that utilize embedded technology to communicate and interact. So the major benefits of Internet on Things in the case of learning can be learner is a part of learning system. Continuous tracking of learner by the system, continuous update to the learner. These are all the important objects or benefits as far as learning is concerned. And another important recent trends, that is cloud-based e-learning. We are all using cloud for storing. This type of e-learning is creating impact in the field of education and business. This learning system are hosted on the internet and can be easily accessed by logging into a service provider site. We know this is done by learner management system LMS, which is also gives the designer the ability to store information on the cloud. We can be remote accessed by this. Clear. It is very faster and cost effective, easy to maintain, large volume of data can be stored. So these are all the important benefits while we are using this cloud based e-learning. And another one that is gamification. Gamification means use of games for learning. Now students are kids or childs below 5 or 4 years, they are learned something through cartoon videos. How they are learned? With the help of these cartoons. They are learning different languages, even Hindi language or English language, with the help of these cartoon videos. That is called gamification. Gamification is the use of game-based mechanics, aesthetic and game thinking to engage people or motivate or promote learning and solve problems. So basically it is the use of gaming technology to solve a problem outside the game sector. Games are created to draw people into, keep them playing, keep them interested, keep them retained, etc. And it is an instructional method and not just the delivery system that provide the element for learning in game situations. We must ask what pieces in the game make them engaging, such as the interactivity, connectivity, story, etc., etc. Okay. Then next one, that is adaptive e-learning. It's also another recent application. That is, that uses computer as an interactive teaching devices. Interactive media, computer is using as an interactive media. This methodology arranges the allocation of human and mediator resources according to the unique learning needs of each learner. Okay, then adaptive learning system can be implemented on the internet for the use in distance learning and group collaboration. It is widely applied in the distance learning process, these adaptive learning methods. And next one, that is augmented reality. Augmented reality means we are creating some real world to learn. For example, Google Classroom is a augmented reality. Creating a, what we say that, a real world, creating a real world. It's not a real world, creating. This technology superimposes a computer-generated image on a user view of real world. It's mainly applied in a business or industry. In industry, some of the development has been taken places. No mistakes can be compromised. No mistake can be tolerated. Even on single mistake while we are producing an article or a products. So what we have to do before producing these products, we will create some augmented reality in order to prove the quality, in order to avoid these mistakes. So this technology needs devices, internet, softwares and hardwares. This is very good application in future in learning. Okay. Then next one, that is video e-learning. It's no need of explain. We know how to use this video in e-learning. It's a kind of learning, helps the learner to grasp the content by watching the videos. TV, CDs, YouTubes, etc, etc. So you know how to use this video e-learning. No need of explain. The next one, that is beacon e-learning. It is a recent important method. It's a widely using methods in developed countries in America. Many universities and colleges or reputed institutions are using this kind of technology, beacon e-learning. Many colleges or campuses are utilizing beacon technology and developing mobile apps to improve their campus Wi-Fi experience. So we can how it can be used? This is a method that transmit signals to other nearby devices via low energy Bluetooth connections have become a hot topic on college campuses. We are using beacon technology can wirelessly transmit information to students within a specific range. In this article, it's highlighted the way beacon technology can improve college campuses and provide examples of how actual colleges are using this technology today. This is used an indoor positioning system, IPS. So how can be used with this beacon learning? It is under this method, data or informations are signals on devices that transmit signals wirelessly by using a Bluetooth devices. So in our colleges or in our campus, we can use this beacon e-learning. So it is very easy to implement this method in a closed area, just like a campus. Campus navigation is very easy by using this technology. More powerful communication than internet communication. It is increased intellectual discovery. Okay, so it's another important application of this e-learning. That is a beacon e-learning. Then the last one, that is artificial intelligence. Now we are working this era. AI, artificial intelligence. That means, now in China, robots are used for diagnosing corona diseases. And they are prescribing medicine, they are giving some instruction to the
those people who have corona affected. So that is an application. And even in developed countries, robots, people are using robots for developing medicines for coronaviruses. So that is an application. Is a technology that can also be great importance to e-learning world. Artificial intelligence or robots are some things. It's an intelligent software which is designed to make some intelligent actions regarding reading entire environment around it. We know how intelligent artificial intelligence can be applied in the area of e-learning. Okay, that's all about the major technologies in the e-learning process. Now we can see what are the approaches of e-learning. There are four approaches we have in e-learning process. We know e-learning is the process of learning, teaching and learning through electronic platform. There are different media. We are already discussed how, which are the types of media that deliver text, audios, images, animations, streaming videos, many, and already explained the applications, etc. So approaches means methods by which learning replaces other learning and teaching approaches. First one, that is synchronous. Synchronous or asynchronous, both we are discussed simultaneously. Synchronous or asynchronous, that is the two approaches of e-learning. Synchronous learning, that is in real time. That means in synchronous learning approaches, all participants increasing at the same time. That involves the exchanging of ideas and informations with one or more participants during the same period of time. Clear? I will give an example for that. Skype conversation or virtual classroom, etc. And examples for these synchronous approaches. Basic point behind is that all participants interacting at the same time. But in the case of asynchronous approach, learning is self-paced and allows students to engage in the exchange of ideas or information without the dependency of other students' involvement at the same time. Clear? For example, blogs, emails, wikis. Okay, we are using these technologies. So here, it's a student-centered teaching method that uses online learning resources to facilitate information sharing outside. Clear? This is the approach. This is a two approaches, synchronous approach and asynchronous approach. In this asynchronous approach, there is no it does not involve a face-to-face interaction as stated in the synchronous method of learning. Okay. But in the case of synchronous learning, it involves the face-to-face interaction that allows to face-to-face interaction. The next one, that is linear learning, that refers to a self-study, which is a computer-based learning. Computer-based learning means CBT, computer-based training or computer-based learning. It is delivered on a computer or a tablet or a laptop or a smartphone that offer user-friendly solution for satisfying continuing education requirements. Instead of limiting students to attending courses or reading printed manuals, students are able to acquire knowledge and skill through methods that are much more conductive or conducive to individual learning preferences. This computer-based training or CBT is often used to learn static processes such as using softwares or completing mathematical equations. That is similar to web-based training. It's also known as WBT. That means the primary difference between these WBT is delivered via internet, by using internet. Here we are using computer. That is linear learning. Then last approach, that is collaborative approach, that is a mixture. Collaborative learning is a mixture. It's a learning approach where students are able to socially interact with other students as well as instructor.
In other words, learner work together in order to expand their knowledge to particular subject or a skill. This is typically done through live chat or message boards or instant messaging, etc. So that's a collaborative approach refers to a direct transfer method in computer-based learning and a training system. Clear? So this use blogs or wikis and cloud-based document portal, etc. So that's all about e-learning approaches. So by these words, let us conclude this module here. Okay, so I think we have already completed 2 modules from our 5 modules. We have only 5 modules. We are already completed 2 modules. At the end of these modules, I would like to give an assignment, that is a brief description about e-learning in India. How India is, how far India is equipped with e-learning, how students are equipped, how teachers are equipped, and what is the statistics regarding this e-learning in India, what about e-learning in India, etc. And one more topic we have, what is the future, what is the prospects of e-learning in India. So please prepare these 2 assignments. It is very easy, only because of we are facing this, we are doing, or we are practicing, and we are observing a number of universities and institutions are offering e-learning platforms and e-learning through different modes and different approaches in the light of this COVID lockdown. So I think all of you are capable of prepare these 2 assignments. All of you please submit these 2 assignments only through Google Classroom. Okay, thank you to all.